So yeah, I interlocked my locks, and just a couple things I want to say about them. Okay, I don't want to say that because this is not an interview. Okay, let me try to recuse the little over. Heaven's watching. Making this video again, but I'm making it again just because my hair was looking crazy, y'all. No, I interlocked my locks, and I'm really excited that I did that because I feel confident that they're actually, like, the issues that I was dealing with is actually going to cease. The issues that I am dealing with are actually going to cease, not is. Now, I feel like my locks are a lot more durable. But anyways, yeah. Okay, so Erin, what we not gonna do is flip our hair the whole video. Pick a style, sis. I feel like I never wear my hair up actually in videos. We're just gonna put it up anyways. Let's just do that real quick. So I don't know if I'm actually gonna interlock the next time I need to retouch my hair. But what I did really like about the interlocking was just how kind of seamless it was, even though it did take me 3 days. But it only took me 3 days because I had to figure out how to actually interlock my hair and just figure out some kinks and whatnot and like learn the rotations and whatnot. So I do feel like it was a little bit seamless, more seamless. But mostly what I really enjoyed about it was my head didn't hurt. Like, it wasn't a painful process. I don't know about y'all, but for me, when I retwist my hair, it hurts. Just like pulling and, you know, wrapping your hair and all that stuff for like 3+ hours. Not 3 hours, I'm joking. Like 2.5 hours just puts a lot of tension on your head. And I did not have that tension this time. That's like really the main thing for me. Like, I don't even realize how much, just retwisting can be a lot just because of the tension that you feel like all up in this area when you're doing it and like the after effect. I felt none of that. So it didn't feel like I was retwisting my hair. It didn't feel like my hair was getting messed with. You know what I'm saying? So that's a big plus for me. It did take a long time though, y'all. I didn't realize that, you know, like I was gonna spend like about 7 minutes on one lock. I ain't realize that. So that's something to like consider and something to think about moving forward. The rotations though, okay? Well, I ended up doing 2 2-point rotations and then 1 4-point rotation. So in the back, I started with 2-point rotation. Then when I got to the middle, I ended up switching over to 4-point. And then by the time I got up to the top, I just went back to 2-point. Just because I had seen a video on 2-point And those are all the videos I had seen. And 4-point just looks so much more complicated. I'm like, I'm definitely rolling with 2-point. Did 2-point. I just didn't feel like 2-point was working or sturdy. I still don't know if I did it right. But I just didn't feel like it was working or it was sturdy or whatever. So I started going to 4-point. I started going to 4-point in the middle. And I liked it. But by the time I got to the top, I just went ahead and went to the one to the four. Pick a number, sis. I went ahead and went back to the 2-point because I learned that it was easier anyway. But I don't need this video to be super long because I mean I got edited and I ain't got time for that. So that's really it. I really hope and pray that this is the solution, y'all. I'm definitely gonna do an update to let y'all know how it looks in like 4 weeks because we're gonna see what's up. But yeah, I do have questions though. It's a lot I gotta learn, like bunching. I had a lot of bunching going on when I was pulling the lock through the loop. Frizz, I still have a lot of frizz. Like, not at the root, which is great, but my locks are frizzy at the base. What's up with that? Yeah, I know that there's a cleaner way to do interlocking. I just don't know how yet. So I'm definitely here for all the comments. Or none of the comments, you know, either way, it's cool. And that's all I have to say. So I will talk to y'all later.